Hello everyone, name's Chase, and today we'll be continuing our journey into the Darkest Dungeon. I plan on doing this episode a bit shorter to save you guys some time and myself too. I'll probably do it about half an hour or something like that, see how much time it takes. It should be about 2 dungeons per episode until it gets further on, but it's probably gonna be just one because they're a lot longer and a lot harder to do. Let's jump right in.
Something long absent in the sunken faces of passers-by. A glimmer of hope.
Nice. So, last time we just came out of one of the dungeons and we recruited 2 more heroes, which we will use one of them to go on the next dungeon because buddy here is in rehab, as I like to call it, because stress relief doesn't sound that good. Rehab sounds a lot more edgier. I'll take the occultist. He's kind of a DPS fixer slash healer maybe, because he does have a heal. Although this heal is, as you can see, it's from 0 to 12 and it has a chance to do a bleed. Most of the times with my luck I don't get any heal and he just bleeds his allies. We'll go for one of these quests, which is a small one, because my heroes aren't equipped well enough to do a longer or a medium run because their armor is still not upgraded, and I'll do the first 2 or 3 things to unlock the rest of the buildings in the hamlet, and then I'll probably go for the longer and medium ones. Let's jump right in. Holy Quanterity, that's nice. Okay, I'll do this one because it's exploration and I don't have to do all of the rooms you can go into. I can skip probably 1 maybe or 2. I'll equip this trinket, accuracy and dodge, minus dodge, so I should put this on someone that has a lot of dodge. He seems decent. I won't put it on my healer because actually I would put it on my healer because she doesn't have any dodge to begin with and she would just get some accuracy boost and some less stress. Because she does have fear of unholy, and when we go in, they will do 15% more stress to her. Oh, sorry. So let's get that fine cuisine, because look at this guy. He doesn't sell anything else besides fine cuisine. I'll get 12, so I can feed them 3 times, unless someone has, like, worms or something like that. Because there's some quirks that actually increase the amount of food they eat. And there's also some quirks which decrease it, which is good, but at this point we'll just get 12. We get 2 shovels and 1 of each. Well, actually, I'll get 2 holy waters because most of the curios in this dungeon are holy related. Holy water does good, and medicinal herbs also is nice to have at least 2. Like that. Let's embark. This mode is supposed to be easier, but easier on your time, not on your heroes, because they will still get a lot of punishment.
Pace out the halls of your lineage once familiar. Now, Orin.
Nice, we start with a double explore, because sometimes it's just one, up to one, like a room of distance. But this time it's 2, so we can see what we have around us. If I explore these 3 rooms, I can decide not to go in one of them if there is a battle and my guys are either overstressed or not enough help. I'll go this way so I can see what we have here. This curio is really good because it has a chance of either healing some of your stress and healing your HP or giving you a buff. And I'll use it with the Crusader because he does have stress, and if he gets either, is gonna be good for him because he's one of my damage dealers. Nice. 30% damage, that's gonna be quite useful considering how much damage he does already. He has 40% damage because of his quirk, because it's the light is strong enough, and these buffing is gonna be really good. The first fight we go into is not so nice because this character, the Madman, is a rare spawn and he's usually tougher than the others. I say as I give him a crit for 7 damage and reduce his dodge. But usually he is really difficult because he deals too much stress on your heroes and puts some debuffs which are kinda nasty. Come on, Crusader, deal 6 damage. Most of the time when you're playing, if you're playing, all the enemies you have will get to a point where they're having like 1 HP or 2 maybe. It's quite annoying and you can't avoid it. I've tried like... Oh! That's some serious damage. I tried buffing like I am now with damage, but it just happens so RNG screws you over regardless of what you're trying to do. This thing is bad because it lasts until the end of the quest, or unless you remove it with one of these medicinal herbs, it really increases the stress your character is getting. Come on, guys. There we go. At least he's gone. Oh no. This archer dude is really difficult because he's always at the back. He does insane damage and I think he does more critical. At least his chance to crit is higher. This dude doesn't concern me that much because only thing he does is stress. And especially on the highwayman because he has a lot of critical and most of the time he gets the kill. He gets also some stress heal. Please hit him. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms. I'll try and clear out these corpses. Make him unable to shoot, although this is probably gonna be the last round. Heal or deal damage? I'll go with the heal. Or it's not so good considering that it could be up to 12. She has Fear of Unholy, which makes her less accurate. Press this advantage. Give them no quarter. Okay, okay, not so bad. Oops. You could feed your characters out of combat, and you can do it up to 4 times. But the weird thing is that after you heal them, if you make a step into the corridor, it could ask you to make them eat again, which is kinda not thought very well, because if you make this character full, he steps to twice and you need to feed him again, although even after you feed them you can't feed him again. It's really weird. I get it, it's a mechanic that needs to be in the game, but not for all of them if one of them is full. Also a nice thing, oh, there's the hunger I was talking about. Also, another thing I've thought about when playing this game is, since the corridors, they made them like not so straight, but it doesn't affect any of the gameplay. It's just a straight corridor and that you just go through it. It doesn't matter if it's has like turns or anything. It doesn't show visually or anything. I thought that if you could make the corridors like spread out so you can go in on one side and it's gonna be a dead end, you have to go back. And also if you put some friendly NPCs in here, because you do have, just a second, you do have these humanoids who are walking around, why not some of them make them friendly, so they give you like smaller side quests or give you items or you free them from some of these bandits or occultists that are just walking around. Okay, now I really have to heal him. That's what I'm talking about. Sort of. These maggots are quite easy to kill, but all they do is stun. And if they stun three out of four of your characters, you're pretty much screwed. There you go, that's a nice crit. 10 stress, nice. I'll do a heal on this guy. 5. Fair enough. A good strategy for the Vestal if... Oh, nice. A good strategy for the Vestal if you go for healing is to do a quest that gives an item that gives healing, because at the minute she's quite not so good, because 1 to 2 is not so nice because you have 4 characters and if they're missing 9 HP each, healing them for 2 won't do much of a difference. These are journal pages which reveal part of mini stories from previous explorers who came in through here. But I won't read this one until I get all of them, so I can just show you guys the story in its complete state. Yeah, you're not only just bleeding. You'll be fine, it's still damage. I like playing in brighter environment because this guy now does a lot of damage. And I tend to give them items which give the bonuses if the torch is bright. Yeah, see now, when they're just some brigands walking around, they could have some hostages, for example, or something that you, after you free them, they give you something back. You do get loot, but it's not the same. It's gonna make it the same when you free the guy, gives you something, but it's gonna be a twist to it, which could be nice. This thing just reduces. I'll try and stun the big guy, although the chance is not so nice. Okay, good. And I'll just hit him. Ooh, 12. If you could do 15 next time, I'll be grateful, Draenor. The Vesto is good against these guys because they do a small amount of damage to everyone. And if you just out-heal that, please heal too. There we go. Most of the abilities everyone cast do not so much damage, but they have a debuff accompanying them, and that's what makes them really useful. Because this guy does hexes, they do pretty much no damage, they do either 0 or 1, but the hexes themselves are really nice. Oh, stop dodging. Can I heal again? Oh, 4 damage. Oh, come on. This game is based on RNG in its entirety. Everything that happens mostly is not good for you and leads to the death of one or all of your characters. There we go. We can use some crits. Do them too. Seriously, dude. Didn't you go to med school for this? You should be able to heal more. I bleed, yeah. I bleed internally too. Oh, we got some bandages. Few damage. He'll be fine because he has the most HP. I'll treat her, and I'll actually remove this because it's 10%. Might not seem much, but when you stack it up with all the other things, it does get a lot. See what this bookshelf has. A map. Nice. Convenient. It didn't explore all the way to the end. Oh well. I'll probably end up not going into this room because this one is empty. Save me a battle too. Because now we have 2 left. Yeah, room battle and another one. There are 2 battles left. Although there's a trap. And each and every of these characters has a 10 base and 10 more. Doesn't seem so good, but this is why we have the Highwayman for, because his trap disarm is 90%. Okay, we can deal with another hunger proc. At later difficulties, there's so many things scattered across the corridors, and the corridors do get longer. And most of these things are traps, so if you don't have someone that can... Game, why do you hate me so much? With a singular purpose. 60 stress. This mode is supposed to be easier. Give me something nice, at least. Glittering gold. I've seen better, but I'll take it. For the beginning, you need to gather all the resources you can, because you're gonna need them for upgrading a lot. At later stages, especially towards like half through the game, you won't be needing some resources that much. Okay, I'll probably get her first because she does no stress. I could deal with the damage unless he crits, but the stress has to be taken care of first. No, no. It's 19 per cast. If she crits, she does like 40, and that's devastating. Okay, she's taken care of. Now I can start healing. Resists. Cool. But not hits. Not cool. I could put a bleed on this guy. So it just... Even if I don't hit him, it takes some of his HP away. 8. That's even better. Nice. He doesn't have that much of a percentage. But when you see it happen, it's so satisfying. Accompanied to the guy with the guy's voice. Oh. Yeah, you have that right. This is the only guy that hasn't had his turn, so I'll try and stun him. So his turn is just wasted. Yes, I know you're bleeding.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Heal. 3. As long as he doesn't get critted, which is probably gonna happen. Oh, good. Come on, Doc. I'll call him Doc, because I rely on him on healing too much. Yeah, 6 is fine. Maybe. Yeah, 6 is fine. Oh, come on, he's first now. I'll try an AoE heal this time. Maybe next time. Ooh.
These nightmarish creatures.
What's in this chest?
They can be beaten.
More resources. Oh, they're both empty, so I do have to do this one though. Because if I want to finish the quest, I have to go in it.
Packs laden with loot are often low on supply.
My heroes are quite low on HP. That's not much of a heal. Inventory management is really important in this game, because when you have half of your inventory taken by resources you are going to use, it's not so nice. I'm not sure if I'm gonna need the torch, because if I go here, then there's one combat, so yeah, okay. Not so much damage. I'll start healing. 6, not too good, but since it's a critical, it heals some stress, which is gonna be pretty much nullified by this guy, but hey, nice. Just keep getting... Just keep critting and we should be fine. Oh, come on, don't target him, all of you.
Another abomination.
Hit one down, but is this guy... 5, okay. This could be bad if they decide to go for her. 2, 1 HP. That's more like it. Make some recovery. Although at this point, when the exploration is... Oh!
Reeling.
So this is what happens when you get to 0 HP. You get this debuff, which goes away after he gets healed. But at this point, it's really bad. When you remove it, it still sticks, but it's like a lighter version on it. And if I actually manage to heal him before he dies, you'll see. Okay, I thought he's gonna go for this mess. I should start putting names on them. Also, now you hit him. Okay. So, it's a lighter version, but it still stays until the end of the quest. And nothing can remove it unless you go camping, and some characters have skills that remove that. Hidden treasures. Yeah, that HP looks a bit better, and also go through. Oh no, I won't. This thing we just saw, this orb that was just sitting there, it's a mini boss that you can activate if you want to. If you think you can handle him, you could do it. You shove a torch in that thing, and the boss spawns. It's not so good because the boss is really difficult. Well, the boss itself is not, but he calls in some reinforcements that really, really mess you up. We'll go through this. It's just a torch. Alright, I guess. And we'll go see what this curio is. If it might be some extra treasure, you just have to go through the like 3 blocks for it. Unless we get the food proc again and we starve. Oh, we'll step in that. There you go, some stress relief. Yeah, that was useful. That was pretty much useless. Anyway.
The shifted corridors and sloped walls of our ancestry are beginning to feel familiar.
Everyone gets one of them. Damn. Most of them is probably gonna be bad, and some of them might be good, but we'll see. This is good. No, actually it's not, because he doesn't have any ranged skills. This is not so bad. This is okay, because he does have a lot of speed, and this gives him 2 more. God fearing is not too combat, like, crippling. This is good, and Gabler is also not so bad. Most of these are related to stress relief, because the guy that got gambling now, I have to put him gambling.
The plume and the pistol. A fitting end to my folly. And a curse upon us all.
So I have to put him gambling, although because this is a quirk. He has a higher chance of losing money when gambling, and that might cost me like 1,000 or 2,000 or maybe a trinket if I have any. Some trinkets are class restricted and they do tend to give just bonuses, but this class especially, the Jester, I don't use that much because to use him you need to have a group of people who have higher mobility, like their skills make them move back or forth because most of his skills make him move back or forth, and if you're not making him move, you're kind of wasting them. So just sell it because I'm gonna need the gold. Okay, we unlocked the blacksmith and the guild, which is nice because now everyone.
Once again, the forge stands ready to make weapons of war.
Yeah, I'll do that a lot. When he starts talking, I'll just shut up, even if it interrupts me in mid-word or sentence. So everyone that's over level 0, which is after they do just one dungeon, they are able to get their skills upgraded, as long as I've unlocked it here. I'll trade up some resources and try to unlock the armor first because that gives a more survivability chance. Each week you get different heroes, and now we have 3 because we upgraded this a bit. Nah, the upgrading is better. They added this abomination class a while ago, and the thing is that he has a lot of skills, but he has this skill transform, which is this, and gives him a lot of things, makes him use some of his abilities you can see here, because in his human form he can use just these 4, and when he transforms he uses this and these 3. He's really good, but the thing is that all of these religious characters, like the Crusader, the Vestal, I think there's 1 or 2 more, they don't want to be in a party with him, they just refuse to go out there because he's an abomination. And you have to pick your party accordingly so you can send him in. Also, heroes that have some stress relief are good with him because every time he transforms it gives 8 stress to the whole party, which is not good. And every round he is transformed, he takes some stress damage himself. He's quite tricky to play with, but if you know how to play with him, he's really good because his damage output is insane. We'll put 2 of them at least in rehab and we'll take 2 from here. Well, we could put 3 of them and take 2 of the characters. I'm not going to take him now because I don't have the necessary characters and trinkets to be able to play with him without punishing my party too much. I'll take the Bounty Hunter and the Grave Robber.
The promise of payment. Make no mistake, we will face ever greater threats. Our soldiers must be ready. Every creature has a weakness. The wise hero trains for what he will face.
Upgrading these two is essential. Well, upgrading everything is essential, but these two keep you alive in combat better, because when you have a better heal or better damage, it's pretty much good for the whole party. I'll trade them for some deeds. These are crests, deeds, portraits, and busts. Yeah, exactly what I said. I'll try and aim to get more of these deeds, because the deeds and the portraits are harder to come by, and if there are any quests offering these things, I'll probably go for them first. So let's do a distress relief. Reynold is god-fearing and he will only go for praying. So I'll put him here. He's not... She's only just praying, so I won't put her anywhere, at least for now. I'll use her again, hopefully she won't go crazy. You're just gambling, don't lose any of my money. And this mask, I think he can't gamble. Gamble, sorry. He... won't pray. So flagellation it is then. I don't have any other trinkets. Okay, nice and easy. There goes the bar. After a few more dungeons, you'll probably unlock the boss. I could go in the wild and get some portraits, but I'll probably go for this so I can get some deeds to upgrade my buildings. She does have Fear of Unholy, which is permanent now. After you get a character and he spends some time with one of these negative quirks, they become permanent and they can't be replaced. And they cost a lot more to remove. But at the minute, I don't have the sanitarium open, because this is where you cleanse their ailments. So she's supposed to be to the back. She throws daggers a lot. Could you... I think she's fine in level 3, I mean in position 3. You go at the back. You seem to be good in second. And you could go in number 1. Oh, sorry. You can go in number 1. You go in second. I'll give her this again, because at this point it doesn't take any dodge away. You can't go negative. So it's just 0 and that's it. But this is really nice. Leper, I have a leper. Yeah, I'll go with this because this is a leper. And after I finish this, I could give him this armlet, which gives him pretty much the same damage as this. But the virtue chance is not that much to begin with. But if you have 3% less and you try not to get him to go insane, it's not that much of a negative thing to have. Some of them gnomes. Some characters, when you take them to a quest, they bring up some things of their own. The leper brings the medicinal herbs and the grave robber accordingly brings the shovel. Some of them don't for some reason, but it would be kind of odd to have 4 heroes and they all bring something. Although it would be useful. I'll get 2 of these, 2 holy water. Yeah, this should be good. I didn't see what the goal was for this dungeon, but the easier ones are either explore or eliminate, like clear out.
The seat of our noble line.
And when they get to medium and long, they could be gathering, cleansing, along with other things. Two extra torches, that's nice. We won't have to go in the dark. There's a trap, and at the minute, I think the Grave Robber is the best choice. If she's low on HP, I'll probably go with the Bounty Hunter because I don't want to risk her dying or at least getting on this door. Getting on this door gives the hero in question more stress and some stress to the others. This is not scouted, so we should be careful for some enemies. The spiders are really could be really difficult if you don't know what to do against them because they mark and then every consecutive hit they do does a lot of damage. Luckily, the Grave Robber is really good with these knives. Oh, nice. It's for a class we don't have, but these are really good because this class, when I get it, she can do bandages, which heal, and when you put this, it does heal a lot more. It's a map. Okay, let's march forward. 70 stress. I presume she will go crazy at some point. 10% protection. Oh yeah, that's her newest positive quirk. We'll try to get rid of this because she's a Vestal. We can have her be afraid of what she's fighting. Stone seems bent on preventing passage. Okay, the food. A bit early. Well, not a bit. A third of the way. Let's see what these books have. Nice. Evasive. This is really useful because if you put her in the front or even in the back, 15 dodge compared to some of the others that don't have any, it's really nice. Okay, let's see what monsters we face here. Oh, these guys. Throw daggers at two targets at the same time, which is really good. This thing reduces their damage and their accuracy. I'll try and stun one of these. The Bounty Hunter is really versatile because if you have some other character that can mark targets, when you do, the Bounty Hunter does extremely large amounts of damage on marked targets. Although at the moment, because they don't have all their skills, I don't have anyone that can mark. There we go, one down. They don't shoot in the first two positions, but they do at the last one. Also, if they're stunned, he does extra damage as well. Like, if they're marked, he does 90% more damage, so that's from 4 to 7. But still, 14 damage is a lot. We should get this guy before he moves to the back. Nice. Doing attacks that catch two targets is the better option most of the time because you have a higher chance of crit. Oh, he got stunned. Too bad. Okay, this wasn't so bad. Just some damage, but she will heal that off. Foolish horrors brought low and see what's in this chest. More food. I wouldn't eat this food. Like, if you just found it in a chest in some decrepit ruins, I wouldn't eat that, regardless of what it is, even if it's canned. She's taking care of a lot of the enemies really fast. Oh, there goes the Vestal. Oh, and she got the runs. The diseases here are really, really bad. You have to take care of them almost immediately. The moment she leaves, she has to get some treatment because minus 20 dodge, although she doesn't have any now, but if you put this on this character, it pretty much screws her up because if the character's strongest trait is dodge and this thing takes 20 away, that's really bad. The max HP is not that bad because her HP is 24, and in this case it takes just 2. Oh, don't miss. There we go, one less. If he blights, nice. I'll try to heal. Yourself 3 HP. The slow death. Oh, no loot. Damn. Forgiving. There's a box, which is empty, sadly. No, don't touch things. And you get blighted. This is the kleptomaniac, because she tends to steal items, and most of the time it just lashes back in her face. Like other things, they're gonna lash in her face when they send her to the Broteo for some stress relief. Oh, come on, stop touching things. I didn't even... Oh, nice, another note. Cool. He said he's gonna keep it for himself, but he didn't. That's good enough for me. Thieving bastards. There we go, still. Two damage, not too bad. Ooh, 14, that's pretty good. I don't think she'll have a problem with stress. Please heal some. No.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it?
I'll give it to her.
Trick of the light.
30% damage. Considering she hits 2 targets at a time and she's almost always first, this is nice. We can deal with a trap. Stealing? Oh no, another note! He took it. Otherworldly corruption. I could try with her, but in the worst case, she's just gonna go insane. Oh, yeah. Mind that such when he stressed on her, would have been one off going mad. Oh, I do have a lot of food. We use that. There's nowhere else to go, so I'll just use it.
The light, the promise of safety.
Not so much loot this time, but I hope these guys, because they're tougher, will give up some more. You have to get stunned. If she hits the vest though, she's done for. Oh, not done for, but it's gonna make the fight difficult. He's stunned, I can't stun him, he's too far off. Come on, you have a buff, you're supposed to be doing more than that. Ah. Three damage is manageable. 7, yeah. Okay. He could take some stress. Oh, come on, everyone. Oh. Death waits for the slightest lapse in concentration. Come on, do more damage. Where are these nice crits I've been looking for? I'll bandage him. Okay, she's done for. Gonna save me some trouble. Okay. Should I just finish him? Or rather heal. Oh, okay, the stun is still fine. Hit him for a lot, just like that. HP doesn't matter after a certain point because you know the dungeon is gonna be over and you haven't got anything else to do.
Seize this momentum.
Oh no. Well, there's nothing else to do, so going back. We didn't get any of these, but we got a buzzer reward, so do something. God fearing. Yeah, this could be a problem, because if everyone has this, and I can cure just one of them at a time, so not so well.
I was lord of this place before the crows and rats made it their domain.
Okay, this is bad because Dismas has left and he will be unavailable for like a week or two. I could play with someone else, but still. Planetarium, Nomad Wagon. Yeah, this thing is where you can buy some artifacts, but they're insane.
Gathered from all the forgotten corners of the earth.
But they're insanely expensive. Yeah, I'll get more next week. Ah, two Vestals. Well, I could get another healer, although I do have one. Let's see what they have. She's kind of a hybrid. And she's kind of a hybrid too. I could just make them teach, like, learn their other skills, but nah, it's too much gold when you start doing it for every single one of your characters. You're going on some trip. Yeah, they better help you. Business. And I'll remove this because 5 dodge. It does cost a lot, so this is why gold comes in play. This is good, but if I start strictly for gold, I'll probably sell it. Yeah, let's see how I'm on time. Yeah. Well, I'll end this episode here. And in the next one, I'll probably do more dungeons. It doesn't seem like much, but since they take some time, I decided to be the better way. So I'll end this here, and we'll see what we're gonna do in the next video. Hoping guys you watch it. See you guys. Bye.